Hello, my name is Wenping. Have you ever needed a secure way to browse the internet without exposing your IP address? Or do you want to access some geo-restricted content that you cannot access from your country? Or maybe you are a bugbounty hunter and you want to change your public IP address without paying for overpriced commercial VPN services that you don't trust? In this video, I will walk you through step by step on how to set up your own VPN using WireGuard. It is lightweight, fast, secure, and most importantly, it is very beginner-friendly. Whether you are into bugbounty hunting, working remotely, or just care about your digital privacy, this tutorial is for you. First of all, you will need a DigitalOcean account. If you don't have an account yet, you can create one for free. If you want $200 of free credits to complete this tutorial, or to try out some other DigitalOcean features, you can find my referral code in the description below. If you already have an account, log in and browse to the droplet management page. Click on the Create Droplet option to get started. For the region, you can choose any of the available options here. This will determine which country your IP address will be located at after you connect to your WireGuard VPN. For example, if you need to access a website that has only whitelisted IP addresses from the United States, you can select a region such as San Francisco. For data center, just choose what is available. In this case, only data center 3 is available for selection. So let's stick to that. For this tutorial, I will be using Ubuntu 22.04, but please feel free to choose a newer version when you are setting up your own WireGuard VPN. It is recommended to choose one with LTS though. LTS stands for long-term support. Next is to choose the size. There are multiple different types of CPU options, including the regular, the premium Intel, and premium AMD. All of them are suitable for running different things. But for this tutorial, I am choosing the cheapest option, which only costs $4 per month. It is more than enough for my personal use. I will not be discussing about the rest of the options like authentication method. If you want to know more about them, you can check out my other video on how to create VPS using DigitalOcean. Click on Create Droplet and we are good to go. Now, we will just wait for the droplet to be created. The process is pretty fast. There you go. Now, your droplet has an IP address. Copy it and use SSH to log in to your droplet. In this section, we will be installing WireGuard on your droplet. After you have logged in using SSH, you can call ifconfig.pro to check your public IP address. Next, let's run apt update and apt upgrade-y to install all updates. When prompted with any interactive selection screen, you can just press Enter to select the default option. After all the updates and upgrades are done, we will be installing WireGuard, qrencode, and resolvconf. So what is qrencode? Think of it as a digital shortcut creator. WireGuard configurations can be long and prone to manual typing errors. So if you ever need to connect to your VPN using your phone, qrencode is capable of translating the WireGuard configuration into a QR code that you can directly scan using your phone. As for resolvconf, when you visit a website, your computer needs to ask a DNS server for its IP address. Now, different connections on your computer, like your regular internet or your WireGuard VPN, they might all want to tell your computer which DNS server to use. If they fought over this, your DNS settings could get messy, leading to either slow internet or even privacy-compromising DNS leaks. resolvconf can act as a central coordinator to make sure that when your WireGuard VPN is active, your computer is correctly told to use the DNS servers provided by your VPN. This ensures all your DNS queries properly go through your secure VPN tunnel, protecting you from DNS leaks and keeping your privacy intact. Next, we will be generating the server keys. Firstly, run umask077. Umask stands for user mask or user file creation mode mask. It is a security setting that determines which permissions are removed from the default maximum permissions whenever a new file or directory is created. So, with umask077, the first 0 typically refers to special permissions like the sticky bit, which we can usually ignore here. The 2 sevens, however, means that we are going to deny all read, write, and execute permissions for both the group and everyone else. As a result, any directories you create will have secure 700 permissions, which means that only you, the owner, can read, write, or access them. For files, they will get 600 permissions, allowing only you to read and write and preventing execution. This ensures strong privacy and security for your new files and folders. Next, run the wg gen key and wg pub key command respectively to generate the private key and public key to be used by your WireGuard VPN server. Next, we will be generating the private key and public key for your client device. You can either generate them on your server and then move them over to your client device, or you can directly generate them on your client device. Both ways works. For this tutorial, we will be generating them directly on the client device. Let's install the WireGuard tools. I am using macOS, so I will be using Brew for the installation. Similarly, let's generate the keys using the same commands we used on the server. Now, we will be setting up the WireGuard VPN server configuration. Create a configuration file. For this tutorial, I named it as wg0.conf, but you can name it anything you like. Insert the configuration file template as shown and replace the server private key and client public key respectively. The server private key was generated previously, so just copy it and paste it into the configuration file. For the client public key, I generated it on my macOS previously, so just copy it over. That's it for the configuration file. For the final step of our WireGuard VPN server setup, browse to /etc/sysctl.conf. This is a configuration file which allows the viewing and modifying of kernel parameters during runtime. In this case, we are going to enable IP forwarding for both IPv4 and IPv6. Apply all changes made and proceed to configuring the firewall. UFW stands for Uncomplicated Firewall. It is a simplified interface for NAT filter, IP tables, and NF tables. Its purpose, like its name, is to make things less complicated because using IP tables directly can be very complicated and prone to error. Allow UDP port 51820 for your WireGuard VPN to work and allow SSH connections. Run UFW enable to activate the firewall. Run wg-quick up wg0 to run your WireGuard VPN. Run systemctl enable wg-quick at wg0 is to make it start automatically and be active every time you reboot your server. Lastly, you can run wg-show to display your WireGuard VPN interface and peer details. Alright, we are almost there. Let's set up the client configuration together. To connect to WireGuard VPN, we need to install a client. For macOS users, we can install it from the App Store. For users on other platforms like Windows or Ubuntu, you all can just select accordingly. In order to import tunnels from file, we will need to create a client configuration. Let's create a client configuration file just like what we did on the server. Once again, we need to replace our client private key and server public key, which is the exact opposite of what we added to the server configuration file. Here's your client private key. Back to the server. Here's our server's public key. Something different from the server configuration file is the endpoint parameter. Over here, you will need to enter the IP address of your droplet. Well, in order to connect to your WireGuard VPN server, your client needs to know where is it located at, right? Finally, we can now import tunnels from file. Select your client configuration file and allow WireGuard to add VPN configurations. Click on Activate. And congrats to you! You have successfully set up your very first WireGuard VPN server on your own VPS. In this case, the IP address is 24.144.90.169. With the VPN, you are now browsing from the United States. By the way, if you only want to connect to your WireGuard VPN using your phone, you can simply use QR and code to generate the QR code and scan it using your WireGuard client on the phone. With this, I have come to the end of my step-by-step tutorial on how to set up WireGuard VPN on a VPS. I hope it is useful to you and can help you with your bugbounty journey and enhance your digital privacy and flexibility. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you face any issues during the setup or have any tips that you want to share with others, please add them in the comments. Have fun and keep hunting!